Welcome to the beautiful flowering plant family Nymphaceae. This is a primitive family coming under the subclass Thalamiflorae and order Ranales. This is a very small family having only 8 genera and about 100 species. The plants of this family are cosmopolitan in distribution. The common members of the family are Nymphaea alba, Nymphaea pubescens, Cabamba furcata, Nuphar luteum, Nilambo nucifera. The common members of this family seen in Kerala are Nymphaea cerula, Nymphaea omarana, Nymphaea rubra, Nymphaea nauchali, Nymphaea pubescens, Nymphaea micrantha, Nymphaea malabarica, Nilambo nucifera, Cabamba caroliniana. Some of the members flower throughout the year, while some others flower only during some seasons. Some members are seen in all the districts of Kerala, but some members are restricted to a few districts only. The plants of this family are perennial aquatic herbs with large rhizome. Rhizome is thick and erect, living for a number of years in the case of Victoria, for a year only in the case of Uriel. Or a branch rhizome can be seen in Nymphaea and Nuphar. The leaves are simple, alternate, usually floating, and either pelted or ovate. The leaves are with large, long petioles. Sometimes they are dimorphic with pelted or ovate, floating and finely dissected submerged leaves as in Cabamba. Leaves are smooth with shining surface, but sometimes becomes prickly below. Example, Victoria. The flowers of Nymphaeaceae are solitary, formed usually on long pedicel. They are large, showy and beautifully colored, bisexual, actinomorphic and complete hypogynous or epigynous flowers can be seen in this family. The calyx and corolla can be called as perianths. The calyx is 3 to many sepals. They are free, green, sometimes they may be petaloid and even larger than the petals, as in the case of Nuphar. In the case of corolla, there are numerous petals can be seen. They are polypetalous, frequently grading into the stamens. Petals large and attractive, but sometimes become minute and scale-like, as in the case of Nuphar. Numerous stamens are seen. Stamens show a petaloid tendency. That means the petals are modified to stamens. Anthers are introns. The filaments are often extended as sterile appendages beyond the anther sac. Gynation consists of simple pistils, each having one carpel. There are numerous ovules and the placentation is marginal. The ovary may be superior or inferior. The fruit of this family is usually a follicle, sometimes a berry or an anterio of indehiscent nutlets. The seeds are with endosperm and perisperm. This family is divided into three subfamilies like Cabamboideae, Nilambanoideae and Nymphoideae. The Cabamboideae family consists of two genera, Cabamba and Brasinia. Nilambanoideae subfamily consists of a single genus, that is Nilambium. Nilambium speciosum is the sacred lotus having long stalked, large beautiful flowers. Nymphoideae is the largest of all the three subfamilies, having 5 genera, characterized by the presence of syncarpous gynoecium and many chambered ovaries. The flowers may be hypo, peri or epigyne. Economic importance of the family. Nilambium speciosum, Nymphaea lotus, Nymphaea stellata, etc. have tuberous underground stem, and these underground stems are eaten by some people. Seeds and flower stalk of lotus are also edible. Tuberous underground stem of Nymphaea nuchalis are used in dysentery to make decoction and to treat diarrhea, cholera, etc. And most of the flowers of this family are used as ornamentals.